Breakfast Club, bitches.
Now, I've been called a lot in my 23 years, but Donkey of the Day is a new one.
Donkey of the Day for Monday, June 11th, goes to New York City radio station Hot 97. Drop on the clues bombs for Hot 97. Legendary. Okay, I'm not going to front on that brand. You can't front on that brand. Staple in hip-hop culture forever. Well, yesterday, as you probably saw on title, they had their annual concert, Summer Jam. I didn't watch the show, so I can't comment on it. I saw Meek Mill's intro to his performance.
Dope.
On Instagram. That was dope.
That was dope.
That was very hard. And I know Timbaland and Switch Beats had a beat battle, which I haven't watched yet, but I plan to. Other than that, I know nothing about the show. But I woke up this morning to a few people texting me and tweeting me, and they were downright disgusted about a tweet that was sent out from Hot 97's Twitter account. Now, we live in an era where I keep stressing to y'all that it's this intersectionality like we have never seen before between the young and the seasoned. Okay, the veterans, the old heads, all right? It's never been like this before, ever. And you need a healthy balance of both. Why? Because you need the youngins to keep us old heads in tune with the little young Uzi Thugs and the rich homie kids of the world. And you need the old heads to prevent mistakes like the one that Hot 97 made last night. Now, whoever was running Hot 97's Twitter account was live tweeting the performances as they should have been doing their job. And Megan Wright was performing. Now, Megan Wright had a special guest come out during her set, and that special guest was the legendary Bun B of UGK. Drop one of Clues Bombs for UGK. All right? Legend does not begin to describe that man. Not only is he a dope MC, he is an exceptional human being. Okay, UGK as a collective arguably could be considered the first trap rappers. Pocket Full of Stones from the Menace to Society soundtrack in 93 was one of the first records I can remember where people were talking about slanging dope. But that's a debate for another day. But what can't be debated is the impact UGK has had on the culture of hip-hop. Okay, well, clearly, Hot 97 had a jitterbug running the Twitter account. If it wasn't a youngin', then it was a culturally clueless, uncultured piece of swine who tweeted out when Bun B hit the stage, "Underground Kings!" with an exclamation mark, then proceeded to tweet, "Pimp C just came out with Megan Wright, hashtag Summer Jam." Now, some of y'all just heard me say that, and it means nothing to you. Some of y'all heard me say that, and you don't believe what I just said. Yes, Hot 97 tweeted out, "Underground Kings, Pimp C just came out with Megan Wright, hashtag Summer Jam." Why is this a problem? And why is Hot 97 getting donkey today? Well, it's because Pimp C has been dead since December 4th, 2007. Okay, I remember this day so vividly because me being the psychological hypochondriac I am, went to the hospital that night because I thought Pimp C died of a heart attack. And I drank a Red Bull earlier that day and forgot how I drank it. So late that night, between having a panic attack, thinking I was going to be found dead like Pimp C and that Red Bull, I rushed to the emergency room. That's just the way my brain works, okay? My anxiety-filled brain, that's just the way it works. And that's how much I love Pimp C. It was on my mind that much. Now, Hot 97 did post an apology. It said, "Earlier tonight, an inadvertent tweet was sent out stating that Pimp C was on stage with Megan Wright. We deeply apologize to family and friends of the late Pimp C, as well as Bun B, for the terrible era. We hold the legacy of Chad Lamont Butler, a.k.a. Pimp C, and UGK dear to our hearts, and will work to keep his rich legacy alive in the future." Now, when I initially saw the tweet, I was like, wow, we really got to step it up for Powerhouse this year because they must have a Pimp C hologram.
Oh, boy.
At Summer Jam, okay? Didn't know that this was just a mistake they made. Let me tell you something, Hot 97. Pimp C once said, "Take that monkey off, you embarrassing us." He stated those eloquent lines on Sipping on Some Scissor. Let's hear that line, please.
"Take that monkey off, you embarrassing us."
And the key words in that bar is embarrassing us, okay? And by us, I mean hip-hop and R&B stations all across the country. You can't say you are where hip-hop lives if you don't even know what hip-hop artists are living. Please give Hot 97 the biggest hee-haw.
Charlamagne Tha God here, and today's Donkey of the Day is brought to you by the law office of Michael S. Lamonsoff. Don't be a donkey and call my friend Michael if you've been hurt in a construction accident. 212-962-1020. That's 212-962-1020. Don't be a donkey!